Hello fans, it's FanMariler here, and I am here to present to you the SD75 physics mod for Train Simulator 2016. It's a quick mod I just threw together in just under 2 hours. Includes the John S. brake fix, so why don't we check it out? So we don't get an echo. There we go. Alright, so here we are in the cab of the SD75M, I believe it is. Yes, I have the M leading. This consists is made up of three SD75s leading. The first two units are M's, and the last unit is an I unit. Although, from an exterior standpoint, there really isn't much to notice. They look identical, so, So from a physics standpoint, I've set the weight of the SD75M at 390,000 pounds, the SD75I is set at 398,000 pounds, and not much of a difference there. Check the brake fix out. Alright, so there's not much to see. It's the direct release brakes, so not much to demonstrate there. Sounds are the same. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Stop. Alright, there we go. That's what I meant to hit. So, as I was saying, the sounds are default. I haven't changed anything other than the RPM upper limit to make sure the sound actually continues to play at 950 RPM. I've changed the RPM range. Idle RPM is 290, whereas the notch 8 RPM is 950, as per the spec sheet available online. The fuel consumption has been altered. Idle consumption is 3 gallons per hour. Notch 8 consumption is 205 gallons per hour. The major changes I've made are obviously to the traction characteristics. The starting tractive effort is 175,000 pounds, up to just under 9 miles an hour. You start to drop off. Wheel horsepower is set at 4,050 horsepower. What else? Dynamic brake is set at around, I want to say, 87,000 pounds, from 22 miles an hour down to 9 miles an hour. Other than that, I mean, it's a typical freight locomotive mod. It's not too dissimilar to the ones I've made in the past. So why don't we test this mod out? What I'm going to do is I'm going to run this out onto the main line from Barstow Yard. I will bring it to a stop at the signal. From that point, I will wrap it up to notch 8 and do an acceleration test to 70 miles an hour. Once we hit 70 miles an hour, I'll cruise for a little bit, then I'll activate dynamic brakes, and we will do a dynamic brake test down to near zero speed. No air brakes, no air brakes. The consist I have attached to these three locomotives is about 3/4 of a mile's worth of auto racks. So I think this consist should at least break 60. I can't guarantee it'll hit 70. I haven't tested it yet. And one final thing I want to note about the mod is that I have adjusted the coupler stretch so that it doesn't stretch as much. So we will take a look at this as we pull out of the yard. Sounds to most of the freight locomotives and passenger locomotives that use DC traction motors. It would be pretty, I want to say it would be pretty simple to do, but honestly I'm not sure if it's worth doing to the point that I'm putting it on every single locomotive mod that I have out there. Okay. Alright, so here we are at the stop signal, right here. We will be beginning our speed test shortly. Once again, we will test acceleration up to 70 miles an hour, and from 70 miles an hour, we will test dynamic brakes down to probably near zero speed. And then I will end this video with the train taking off from the point where we stopped the dynamic brake test. So, sit back, enjoy the ride, and let's begin. We'll start at 12, let's see, let me get myself a... Start at 12:30, so we can have a good minute marker to judge from. I put on this consist when I made it. I just made it as close to 3/4 of a mile as I could. So let's actually count. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 41 cars, 41 auto racks on this consist. So it's about whatever 41 divided by 3 is per engine. So each locomotive is in charge of pulling 13 and 2/3 of a car. I think we'll hit track speed. Switch this icon over to dynamic brakes since that's what we'll be using. 5 minutes. Alright, so we hit 70 miles an hour. It's been 5 minutes and 20 seconds. This is not too bad. I've coded the tractive effort versus speed DCSV file so that once you do hit 70 miles an hour, the tractive effort curve does taper off sharply to zero effort at 73 miles an hour. 3 miles an hour over speed is is the standard over speed setting. Let's do a couple cruising shots from the outside, and then I will switch over to the dynamic brake test. Good section to start the dynamic brake test. So as per standard procedure, we will move the throttle to idle and wait 10 seconds. So when that hits 29, we will start applying dynamic brake. Slack is bunched. Starting dynamic brake test at 20:45. Dynamic brake amps should max out at the black line, which is approximately 700 amps. see, dynamic maximum dynamic brake is a flat curve, extended range from 22 miles an hour down to 9 miles an hour. From 9 miles an hour, it does taper off to zero at 3 miles per hour, at which point we will begin to apply the train brake to bring the train to a stop. I'm gonna just do it now. Alright. So, from 2045 to 2530, it's about 4 minutes and 45 seconds or so. I think that's pretty decent. Bring dynamic brake to zero. So, that concludes the demonstration for this physics mod. Everything else that you would need to know is located in the description. So, feel free to drop by and read that. Download link to this mod will also be in the description like it always is. Yeah, that's it. I look forward to working on maybe a couple more freight mods in the near future. They're pretty simple to do. There's not much to change. It takes about maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours for each DLC, provided the mod doesn't actually break the functionality of the DLC. So I'll look into that. My schedule is still pretty busy, so there's no guarantees. But yeah. So that's all for now. Until next time. See ya.